Governor, I appreciate you coming from Juneau to do this. And I also remember the time that when one would go to Juneau from Saxman, it would be a two-week trip. Mm. You'd have to take it by boat, a week up and a week back, and some of the days that you're going there. And I remember when the whole community of Saxman would go down to the boat to say goodbye to my dad and those who were going up with him. And the whole community would come back down to the float to welcome him home, because he did a great journey to this place called Juneau. When I became mayor of Saxman and went to Juneau, nobody went to the dock to say goodbye to me. Nobody came to welcome me home. So.
Not even your wife?
She was working at the time.
How are you?
Thank you.
Thank you. What about you?
You can ride a bike, you can ride on a skateboard, you can go jogging on it.
He wants his ribstick on that trail.
Oh, man.
We're waiting for the snow to clear.
Be careful. Thank you, John. Thank you.
Good. The legislature is looking to accept all of the stimulus money. How much of that are you willing to take on?
Well, nothing has changed in my mind in terms of what the stimulus package will do to our nation and will do to our state. It grows the national debt, and it forces the state to be in this deficit spending mode, and I don't like that. And look, what this is basically a bailout for many of the states. Look what's happening on a national level with private businesses, where government's coming in to bail them out in order to get in there and have more control of those businesses. Who's to say that the same philosophy isn't going to be used there in terms of bailing out a state and then getting in there and having more control over that state? That doesn't sit well with Alaskans. When you talk specifically about some of the stimulus dollars with obvious strings attached, like the energy building codes that will have to be adopted by local communities who today may not have those energy building codes, but in order to accept the money and spend the money, they'll need the codes. That's another example of a string that is attached. We'd rather see building codes discussed and adopted on a local level and not be mandated by the feds. It was a problem then too, and it was a problem when I first got elected and saw that we still had so many earmarks, for instance, that had been requested under previous administrations, and we scaled that back so drastically that I think we're down to maybe 8 earmarks, is it, Karen? 8 were here in Alaska. We have an opportunity. We have more of an opportunity here than any other state in the nation to be part of the solution and not part of that problem that you're articulating there, Rebecca. And the solution is development within our own resource-rich state. The only way we're going to get to do that, though, is for the feds to give us that allowance to develop.
Governor, a lot of lawmakers say that these types of positions you take have everything to do with just stoking your national image. They say it has not as engaged with the legislature this year as you were in the past. And they say that this kind of conversation right here has much more to do with you thinking about national politics than it does the session in 2009 in Juneau.
Absolutely beg to differ with that. I've had the same fiscally conservative philosophy that's been a part of me ever since my PTA days and city council and mayor and then as governor. No, I'd be saying the same thing if you would have asked me 10 years ago that growing the nation's debt is a problem and self-sufficiency for a state and development of a state is the solution. So,
an ethics complaint against Governor Sarah Palin was filed this afternoon asserting Governor Palin's involvement with Sarah PAC constitutes quote-unquote outside employment. You have an immediate response to that?
You bet. Governor Palin's probably one of the best governors we've ever had, and she's a very dedicated lady, and she's done us a great job by getting Alaska even on the national circuit. And when I got down there, I just saw that she's just being nibbled at by a bunch of ducks almost. These people that look for any type of way to get their name before the news, or don't like to see somebody else being successful. are filing ethics complaints against her and Freedom of Information Act requests against her. And then they complain she can't get her job done, but she's having to respond to all this bogus stuff that's coming out. It's really sad what I saw down there, to see a lady as vibrant and good-spirited as Sarah Palin, just constantly attacked.
Is some of this nibbling at the morale down there, did you witness any of that, or is the spirits pretty good? I mean,
well, she's a very dedicated lady, and she can't get her work done when people are filing ethics complaints that she's got to respond to, and people are filing Freedom of Information requests time after time that she can't respond to.
Right.
And then they come back and criticize her for not getting the work done that she should otherwise be able to do if she didn't have all these little piranhas.
It's great to be here with a good local Kodiak residents, especially the Floyds, whom I see all over the state, and we'll either meet at political events or Alaskana events like this, and invariably our conversation, though, always heads back towards basketball. And I thank you so much for all that you do for all the kids in this state. Huge sports advocates, the Floyds are. Todd and I just got to tour the missile launch facility and reminded me how blessed those who live here in Kodiak truly are, the diversity here with your economy and with all that is Kodiak, as we flew over and saw the buffalo and the elk and the mountain goats. And I just thought, wow, what an absolutely amazing place this island is. The commitment to manage based on biology, not on politics, and the commitment to sustain a 50-year legacy of putting the long-term health of the resource above short-term health of our wallets is what makes fisheries in Alaska special. Back to a little bit of the personal aspect of this for me. My husband, who's been a commercial fisherman all of his life, a drifter in Bristol Bay and now a set netter on the Nishigak. And by the way, on the little trek that we took across the nation when we did our campaign for VP, that little trip we took, it was so cool to get to talk about commercial fishing to people, you know, in the heart of America who they watch The Deadliest Catch, so they think that I'm one of those guys, you know, out there. Because I talk about, I'm a commercial fisherman from Bristol Bay. And, really, you're like one of those guys out there on The Deadliest Catch? And I never had really time to explain. I'm just a set netter on Nishigak, so I kind of left him with that impression, perhaps. But it's really cool to be a part of a commercial fishing family with such history that Todd's family has. His grandpa was a boat builder in Bristol Bay, and back then, of course, fishing out of the sailboats for 5 cents a fish, and way, way, way back in the history of it, Bob King, he was the voice of Bristol Bay, and you're going to hear from him in a little bit. 17 years, he was there on the radio letting us know when the openers were, and just to be a part of that, and now to be in a position to help make decisions that will, we believe, help future generations of Alaskans be able to capitalize on what it is that, well, personally, that Todd and I have so benefited from. So I want to thank, knowing that it takes a whole crew in this industry to make it work, I want to thank other crew members, and that's the fine men and women of the U.S. Coast Guard who are on call day and night to help our fishing fleet.
On behalf of historic Ketchikan, someone gave this to me, and it was probably worn by a kindergartner.
Yeah.
The Borough and Dawson Construction. Hang it in the halls. They're quite wide. They can't be replaced. Thank you very much.
The governor has to get back to important state business, but why don't y'all come in and have a tour?